Hey guys, hi and welcome back. Thank you so much for coming on this series. My name is Aarzoo Shah and the reason I started this series is because I'm on a mission to make India believe in herself. When I say I'm on a mission to make India believe in herself, the reason I'm doing this is because so many times when we are going through our lives, we enter phases of our life, we enter situations in our life where we tend to not believe in our ability to achieve whatever we want to achieve in our life. And we keep giving ourselves different reasons why we can't do what we really want to do in our life. Sometimes it's about the age, sometimes it's about the background, sometimes it's about the resources that we have, and sometimes it's just because I'm not good enough to do something in our life. I genuinely believe that the reason we tell ourselves that we cannot do something is because we do not believe that we have the ability to achieve whatever we want to achieve in our life. And I have been one of those, you know, many examples out there too who believed that I couldn't do what I really wanted to do in my life. And then because I was fortunate enough to go on to study psychology for some years, I went to a lot of trainings and seminars and discovered a way for my own self to believe in my ability to achieve what I wanted to do in my life. I started this video series to reach out to the women in our country who want to believe in themselves and who want to believe that they can achieve whatever they want to achieve in their life. In this series, we have had women across professions coming and talking about why we should focus on our inner beauty and our inner strength, because no matter what you go through in your life, you always have that within you that you can do whatever you wish to do. And our today's guest is also someone who genuinely believes in what she wants to do. And that is the reason that on such a young age, she is loved by so many people in this country and who's achieved her dreams and who's still on the path of achieving her dreams and who's telling us why we should all believe in ourselves and our inner beauty. She's an actress and her name is Aditi Bhatia. Let's hear it from her.
Thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, it's my pleasure.
First, my first question to you is, what is the concept of inner beauty for you? When we talk about inner strength and inner beauty, what does it mean to you?
I think just believing in yourself and not trying to compare yourself with what others are doing in their life is what is your strength, I think. And just to believe in that is what makes you stronger and stronger every day.
Were you always like this? Have you never been in that space where you at times
felt No, not really. I've never been this way actually. I've always been a very insecure child for some reasons. Like I've always looked on to people and been like, you know, wow, she's so pretty. Oh my God, why am I not like this? In school days, you know, every child has this insecurity. But now with time, I think, of course, I'm not still very big enough. I'm not at all big enough, but then still I've somehow figured this that, you know, there's no point of comparing yourself with anyone because it just doesn't make sense. God has made you for a reason, and that reason is that, you know, you are you and you're beautiful. That's it. So I just believe in that now.
Whenever you found yourself in that space where you felt like, you know, is she better or, you know, am I not that good enough? What did you do to come out of it? Now, if you feel that way, what do you do to come out of that zone?
Honestly, earlier I used to be very, very, very depressed. Like I would literally use the word depressed. So there was this time when I used to audition like crazy for advertisements, okay? And earlier since, like I've been working since I was 5 months old. And from that time till today, I have done about 300 brands till now. Like I've done from, like I've been a child model. So it was like a very easy thing for me to get into advertisements. But then after a point, after I grew older and say about 14 or 15, and I started again getting into the audition because again it was getting back to the race of, you know. But then things were pretty different and again I started trying. But then all I faced was just rejections, like back-to-back rejections. I still don't believe it that, you know, okay, someone can reject me that badly. Because I've never been like that because I've always been working, so I don't know what a rejection means. But then that is when I had faced it and I felt so bad because there was this time when always what used to happen was they used to audition me, everything used to go perfect, and according to me, I used to act fine and look fine. But then when it came to shortlisting, they used to shortlist me as well. So if they were shortlisting me, meaning I thought that, you know, okay, I'm doing pretty fine. That is why I'm being shortlisted. But then they never used to select me. And I used to be like, okay, fine. What did go wrong? And obviously, I did not lose hope because it was just once or twice. But then it became on an everyday basis. And I started feeling very low within.
Obviously.
That, you know, what is going wrong? You know, now of course I feel, okay, I was very ugly back then. Okay, I did not know how to do this. I did not know how to do that. But at that point, people around me also did not know how to do this and that.
Yeah.
So people were, actually, according to me, people were a bit lower also and a bit higher also for me. But you know, ek ad to mil jani chahiye thi. That was my concept. That you know, arey itna bhi kya bura hai yaar? Mere mein ke ek ad bhi nahi mil rahi. And also, so I wouldn't name anyone, of course, but always there were these two girls who used to be chosen in every goddamn ad in which I used to try an audition. I used to be very depressed. What is going wrong? What is going wrong? So that is when I hit a good low in my life. My life has been very short, but yeah, that is when I was actually sad that what is going wrong, man? What am I doing? But then now I realize that, you know, God had something for me, and yes, that is why everything was going in that way.
It was leading you to something,
yes,
better.
Yes. And now I feel, even if those girls were better than me or not good as me, or you know, maybe not at all good, or, I wouldn't say that I'm not that good, but yeah, still I'm happy now. Yeah, I'm just content that, you know, wherever every person is, it has to be written, and it's just destined.
Yeah, there's something always better in store for you. That is why you go through that phase.
And now I've understood this, and I'm just trying to adapt it every now and then. And every second of my life, I just keep learning this, that, you know, okay, if this is not happening, there's something better which is going to happen. Because it's just a small experience, but this has taught me enough that God will always have something or the other for me, in waiting for me in the line. And I don't have to just get sad if something doesn't work out.
Do you feel that, you know, this way of realizing that every time you're in that zone, there's something better for you? If this is not working out, it's not meant to be. There must be something better for you. Do you feel that you don't learn that overnight? It's a journey. You keep telling it to yourself every single day. And over a period of time, you learn how to accept it.
Yeah. So basically, it's not a kind of teaching that I could give to someone. And it's not a kind of a teaching which I could take from someone. Because of course, I've been having a lot of mentors in my life, and I've also been reading a lot of quotes and all that which say that, you know, don't give up, don't do this, don't. But it's all about experience. You have to hit a low in your life to, you know, give yourself a boost, and that happens all its own. You don't have to do anything. You just have an experience and you learn everything in your life. That's it. And I wouldn't say that I've learned everything in my life, of course, but yeah, I have had this one experience and it's taught me enough. But also, I'm not quite you know, quite going by it, but yeah, I'm still trying to adapt it. Yeah, God has something for me on its way, so yeah, I'm just patient now.
When you started shooting for this serial and Ye Hai Mohabbatein, and then, you know, it rose to so much fame and everything worked out so well, but when you started this, were you nervous?
I don't think I've ever been this nervous in my entire life till now, and that made me super nervous, because auditions do make me nervous, because I had got so many rejections.
Yes, in past.
Yeah, so I've always been nervous, but at that time it did not matter to me much, because I already had a lot of projects in my hand till then, that I was that strong till then. But then Ye Hai Mohabbatein was, of course, something very, very, you know, interesting and something really like a hit show in your hand.
Yeah.
But I, you know, the baddest thing about me back then, losing hope. Just losing hope. Ki nahi, wo to nahi hone wala. Achhi cheeze to mere life mein likhi nahi hai. Like that. Okay, yeah. So back to your question. So nervousness was when I got selected and I freaked out. Okay, ye bhi ho sakta hai. And then I was narrated the script. And shit, wo zameen khisak jati hai na niche se. That was the thing with me, because I had to become a boy.
Yeah.
And I was like, what? What am I signed up for? What am I gonna do? Are you serious? You know, and there were these minor things which they told me to do, that, you know, walk like a boy, talk like a boy, do this like a boy, do that like a boy. And I'm like, okay, I was not getting selected all this while, when I got selected, I have to do this. You know, that is what goes in your mind. But then, you know, and I honestly, very honestly, I thought, okay, this Rohan the rock star is not going to work, okay? And the moment I'm going to enter the show, people are going to hate me, and it's just going to shut. Because it's all because of me, and nothing is going to happen in my life. And all those thoughts. I overthink a lot. And that is like, you know, one thing, I have one thought, then I have 50 other thoughts. So that is what started happening. While I'm in the narration, I just hope Sandeep sir doesn't listen to this. So he's my creative head. So he was narrating, and this is what was going on in my mind. Okay, no, I can't do this. I don't know if it's gonna work. This that. But it worked so well, and I don't know how did I pull it off. But I don't even know if I played it well. But people liked it so much.
And yeah, you would really appreciate it for that.
For that Ruhan thing. But initially, it was like, because obviously people were so attached to that younger Ruhi.
Yeah.
And of course, people would be attached. The show has been running for 3 years now. And I was like, okay, replacing her. And then seeing the attachment of people was something which was very crazy for me. I had never seen that craze. Like, you know, that craze. Because it was there for me earlier when I was young. But tab to itni samajh nahi hoti hai na. And also, itna, for the first time, I started getting hate in my life. That, you know, who are you to replace her? You know, all those kind of statements that, you know, you look at your face, you can't even act. Our younger Ruhi is the best. Nobody can ever replace her. Ishra Ru is not Ishra Ru anymore. And all those kind of things. So that is when I again hit a low in my life. That, you know, okay, I just tried something and this is how it's going wrong. So there was a lot of hate comments, but then I...
How did you handle that?
Yeah, I switched off my phone. I switched off my phone for straight, I think, 2 weeks. I switched off my phone for 2 weeks and no hate comments, no nothing, just off the world, you know. And after 2 weeks, the TRP was the highest all over TV. Wow. And I was like, okay, now I'm gonna open my phone. And I'm a very phone addict person. Like, I am always on my phone, and leaving the phone was a big thing for me. But that is when I actually thought, okay, I've started working for this. And I actually got into the character. After leaving Ruhan also, I used to work like a boy. I got crazy. So, and I miss Ruhan. Yeah, I seriously miss Ruhan. So Ruhan was supposed to be only for some time, but then they increased it because it started working.
Working, yeah.
And it was like a kind of shocker to me because I wasn't even thinking about it that it's gonna even work, like, you know. But it worked so well, and I don't know how it worked, but people started appreciating my work, and that is when I opened my phone. And then there were so many positive comments. I started reading all of them, started getting happy, started crying. For the first time, I started crying when I was happy. I never knew why do people cry when they're happy.
Yes.
And that is when it happened.
Do you believe that sometimes, you know, these kind of good things, they take time and patience to come?
Yeah, I do believe it. Because it's all experience, as I told you all, that good things do take time. And I have realized it by giving more than 1,000 auditions and not being selected. And then... not having the patience, but, you know, the thing to have the patience and to come to me, that is what I have realized, that, you know. And I just think if more time pe, I should have been much chilled out.
Yeah.
Because I not did not know na ke kuch aane hi wala hai, it's on the way. Now I will be at peace, I think, much more than I was earlier. Just don't give up in your life. Ever, there is something or the other waiting for you, always and always and always. And just be yourself and don't care about what others think of you. And what else? That's it, I think. Just be yourself and just be the way you are. Don't try to enact somebody or trying to become like somebody, because you are what you are and God has made you for a reason. And you're beautiful. I am beautiful, you know.